Bonjour Vivienne, nous sommes le mercredi 25 décembre. So it's Wednesday, December 25th, and this is a summary of what we did on Monday. So let me just go scroll back up. And well, actually, we did some very, very interesting stuff, you know. So we listen to saison 1. You should have the tracks, so just let me know if you don't have them, but I think you have them. And so what we did is to try to locate the sounds and make sentences based on that. Okay, but first of all, so I'm gonna just make sure I can reopen saison 1, so there is not too much to see actually, because it's mostly different tracks. So I'm gonna just start here. And Vivienne, that's the way we should spell the name in France. Quelle heure est-il? Quelle heure est-il? Il est 5 heures. Il est 17 heures. Teur. 5 heures. 5 heures. There's a Q and an E sound. 5 heures. 17 heures. Quel temps fait-il? Il fait froid. Il fait froid ici aussi. Quel jour sommes-nous aujourd'hui? Nous sommes le lundi 23 décembre. Quel jour étions-nous hier? Quel jour étions-nous hier? So that's a verb, étions, this is a subject, nous. So it's like an imparfait. The past tense. It's like, what was the day yesterday? Okay, so we come back to the question and we have the subject and the verb already. So nous étions le dimanche. Hier, nous étions le dimanche. So yesterday, we were Sunday. Quel jour serons-nous demain? So will be tomorrow. What day will be tomorrow? So the future. Nous serons le, every time we say that, nous serons le mardi, nous serons le mercredi, etc. So, quel jour étions-nous hier? What day was it yesterday? Quel jour sommes-nous aujourd'hui? What is the day today? Quel jour serons-nous demain? What day will be tomorrow? Okay? So I ask you different questions, you know, concerning the numbers up to 20. So you good, hein? Keep practicing. Comment tu épelles ton nom? Comment tu épelles ton nom? So c'est V-I-V-I-E-N. V-I-V-I-E-N. Okay, V-I-V-I-E-N. So this is informal. Comment tu épelles ton nom? Informal. Comment épelez-vous votre nom? Comment épelez-vous votre nom? Okay. So, we saw on the book different locations dans la rue, on the street, dans la cuisine, in the kitchen, à la gare, at the train station, okay, et près d'une fontaine, près de la fontaine, près de la fontaine, it's like next to the fountain, so nearby, close by, next to, depending on the context and the syntax as well. So we also, let me see, if we, well, we also learned new vocabulary, not necessarily the, you know, the most interesting, but still practical. We talked about the door, the alarm clock, etc. So just reopen it. So we can make sentences like je suis dans la rue. Okay, I'm gonna just scroll this stuff and see if I can reach. So voilà, je suis dans la rue. So because we know to be and to have present tense, hein? So je suis, j'ai, je suis dans la rue. I'm on the street, or in the street. J'ai une voiture dans la rue. I have a car on the street. Je ne suis pas dans la rue, I'm not on the street. Okay. So, go back to this stuff, it's gonna open, it's just a bit slow. So, Just for the vocabulary, the objects. So, je suis, j'ai. Je ne suis pas, je n'ai pas. Okay? So now, je n'ai pas une voiture dans la rue. That would be logically correct. But in fact, every time I deal with a un, une, des, and I have a negative form, I'm going to say, je n'ai pas deux voitures dans la rue. Ne pas deux, every time I deal with a un, une, des, in the negative form. So, je n'ai pas deux voitures dans la rue. Je suis dans la cuisine. Je suis dans la gare. Je suis près d'une fontaine. Okay? And we can also say, j'ai, j'ai un vélo dans la, à la gare. J'ai un vélo près d'une fontaine, etc. Okay? So now, j'ai ma voiture dans la rue. J'ai mon vélo dans la rue, près d'une fontaine. J'ai mes valises à la gare. I have my suitcases at the train station. Okay. So, normally, it should be here. I don't know why it's doing this stuff. So, yeah, here we go. So, if I scroll down. So, this everything, you know, this kind of textbooks are okay. But you need to add more information in order to complete, you know, the lesson. So, okay. So we also talked about the possessive adjectives, les adjectifs possessifs. My basically can be mon, ma, mes. Mon is masculine, ma is feminine, mes pronoms. Okay. Your, ton, ta, tes. Masculine, feminine, pronoms. So mon, ma, mes, ton, ta, tes. His, her can be a little bit more complex. So here, j'ai ta voiture dans la rue. I have your car on the street. J'ai tes voitures dans la rue. I have your cars on the street or in the street. J'ai ton vélo dans la rue. I have your bicycle in the street. Okay. So far we have mon, ma, mes, ton, ta, tes. Okay. To get that. So if I want to deal with his, her, the thing is, I don't really care if it belongs to a guy or a woman. It's not the problem here in French. The noun that comes after the possessive adjective will give the gender of the possessive. Okay? So, for instance, if I want to say a car, une voiture, so sa voiture can be his car or her car. Okay? So, if I want to say it's his bicycle, c'est son vélo because it's masculine. Okay, so his, her can be son, sa, c'est, son masculine, sa féminine, ses pronoms. So if I want to say c'est son vélo, that means it's her bike or his bike. Okay. Ce sont ses vélos, it's like they are his bicycle. Okay. Next, the third irregular verb we have to study is faire. So we did to be, to have, irregular verbs, present tense, faire, to do, to make. Okay? So you're going to see we use this verb for a lot of activities. So I can say faire la vaisselle, to do the dishes, faire un gâteau, to make a cake, faire une tarte, to make a tart, a pie. Okay? So the way I conjugate it is je fais, that means I do, I'm doing, I make, I'm making. Okay, tu fais, il, elle fait, nous faisons, we don't really say faisons, we say faisons, vous faites, ils font, elles font. So I can say, je fais mes devoirs, I do my homework, je fais un poulet rôti, so it's like I make or I prepare a roasted chicken, je fais des lasagnes, ou je prépare des lasagnes, making lasagna, or you know, I'm making, I'm preparing, you know, we have to be flexible with the translation. But I can also talk about an activity. Je fais de la natation deux fois par semaine. It's like I do swimming twice a week or I swim twice a week. Again. Faire du tennis, faire du jogging. Je fais du jogging, je fais du tennis, je fais de la natation. Okay. So every time we have an activity, if I say I make a cake, it's like je fais un gâteau. So it can be un, une. But I can also deal with du, Je fais du tennis, masculine singular. Je fais de la natation, féminine singular. Et je fais des claquettes. You know, the shoes you dance with, they make a lot of noise. So, des pronoms. OK? And I can also deal with deux à l'apostrophe. We have an activity starting with an H or what's the name? A vowel. Okay. So, coming back, quel temps fait-il? Il fait beau, il fait froid, il fait chaud, etc. Quel temps faisait-il hier? How was the weather yesterday? Hein? Il faisait beau, il faisait froid aussi, il faisait froid, chaud aussi, etc. Quel temps fera-t-il demain? So that's the future. How will be the weather? How the weather will be tomorrow? Il fera beau, il fera chaud, il fera froid, etc. If I want to say it snows or it's snowing, that's going to be the same translation in French. Il neige. Okay? Il neige. So, cuisiner to cook. We reviewed some expressions. Recent past, I just did something. That means je viens de. Okay? Je viens de cuisiner. Just cooked. Je suis en train de cuisiner. It's a present progressive. Je suis en train, I'm currently cooking. I'm cooking. Je suis sur le point de cuisiner. I'm about to cook. So the three expressions here can save you a lot of time. So je viens de. Je suis en train de. Je suis sur le point de. Okay? Je viens de cuisiner. I just cooked. Je suis en train de cuisiner. I'm currently cooking. I'm cooking. Je suis sur le point de cuisiner. I'm about to cook. So, je viens de manger. I just ate. Je suis en train de manger. I'm currently eating. Ah. I'm eating. Je suis sur le point de manger. I'm about to eat. Okay? So, in French, conjugation can be a tiny bit challenging. But basically, we have three groups. So, we have a lot of verbs, lots of way to, lot of many ways to conjugate, but we can simplify. We can say, well, you know, we have three verb groups, and the first one is any kind of verbs ending in er, which is a a sound, except aller, to go. Okay, so all of them except one. So I can talk about travailler, parler, chercher, to work, to speak, to look for. So, how do I conjugate those verbs? Well, I'm gonna drop the er part, okay? Like parler, I drop the er part. I'm gonna end up with root, and I'm gonna conjugate. I'm gonna add the following endings: e, es, e, ons, ez, ent. E, es, e, ons, ez, ent. So, je parle, tu parles, il, elle parle, nous parlons, vous parlez, ils parlent. So, e sound, parle. The same with the verb chercher, to look for. Je cherche, tu cherches, il cherche, nous cherchons, vous cherchez, il cherche. Okay. So, I'll see you Tuesday at 6 p.m. your time, which is like 10 p.m. my time. Okay. You have a one. I think Tuesday will be. Let me check the calendar. So 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. So let me just see here. There we go. 31st. The 31st, the last day of the year. La Saint-Sylvestre. This is the way we called it this day, La Saint-Sylvestre, because it's Catholic calendar. And every day has a very specific name. So anyway, you have an excellent week, an excellent weekend, and I'll talk to you next week on Tuesday, 6 p.m. your time. Take care, Vivian.